Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Ordinary Data Scientist, where we talk about data science. So friends, as I mentioned in my previous video that we will talk about each chapter in one video. So today we'll cover the first chapter, which is Introduction to Statistics. And if you see the chapters here, the units like introduction, then we talk about distribution and sampling and so on and so forth and all. So each unit has multiple chapters. Okay, the first one that we'll cover is Introduction to Statistics. So you might have heard about this term very often, like statistics, very often. But what exactly is statistics? What kind of analysis you can perform with the statistics, where exactly you need them, all those things we will try to cover here, right? So when I say introduction to statistics, so we'll try to cover what exactly it is, where we will use it, and how. So all this aspect we'll cover in the first lecture. Okay, so let's go to the first lecture, which is introduction to statistics. These are the learning objectives that we have, that we want to understand the difference between population and sample. We will talk about some of the data types, and also try to relate with some real life examples also. So let's say you are working for a big MNC. Now, if I present you this case that you have a good market share in India, I mean by the big cities. Now you want to enter into some rural markets, or let's say tier 2-3 cities. So how will you build your strategy, and what exactly should be your strategy to enter into this market? Let's take example, you are a automobile company. Automobile means you manufacture car, mostly car. Now if you already have good market share in this tier 1 cities, those car, if you directly take those car to tier 2 or tier 2-3 cities, those car or products will not perform good, because the income level is different, right? The preferences will be different, and the infra will be different. Like that here, if you talk about the roads might be good, but if you talk about villages and rural area, the infrastructure won't be good. The service center will be very far from, let's say, customer base and all, and then that's why the preferences might change, and income level is little probably in the lower side, so the choice of the car will also be different, right? So that's why you really need to understand all these kind of parameters. For that, you will float a small survey to different kind of villages or tier 2-3 cities. You will select a customer base. Let's say you want to target a customer base of 30 to 50 years old. You will randomly pick 100 or 200 respondents, try to get their preferences, their choices, and then you'll come back to your headquarters, wherever it is, and then you will make a strategy to enter into this market. So this is the importance of statistic. Instead of directly going to the market, instead of entering into these markets with billions of dollars, you try to form a strategy with a small set of respondents or a survey, and then enter into market, right? In a smaller, probably with the smaller steps, right? So these are the different kind of questions that you need to ask, before entering into any market, right? So there are various examples that we can see in our day-to-day life. For example, let me tell you another use case of statistic. In the COVID era, you might have seen that whenever a vaccine came, it went through a lot of trial, like first phase, then we said that it will go through second phase and then third phase, right? You might have heard, you know, this kind of thing, right? Vaccine, when COVID-19 vaccine was going through the trial. Now, this COVID-19 vaccine probably is for entire population. Let's say, I would say 20 to 80 years. Just making it up. Entire population, right? Now, in India, if you have around, you know, 60 crore population falling under this bracket, more than 60 crore, but let's say 60 crore population falling under this bracket, the manufacturer, when vaccine manufacturer, cannot directly start giving the vaccine to all the population, right? They have to check the efficacy, efficiency, and all those parameters in a sample. So in the first phase, they might have selected, let's say, you know, 100 people. When it went well, everything went well, the vaccine showed some good results, you know, it acted or it worked against the virus, then they increase their sample size to, let's say, 10 to 20,000, something like that. Yeah. And when also the second phase results came out, it was really great, encouraging and all, then they increased the sample size to, let's say, 30,000, right? Probably 100, you know, they just took from only one state. Example, here they might have taken, let's say, from 10 states, and here they might have gone up to 28 for all these states, whatever, right? So that's how the, before taking a decision that should the vaccine be in the market or not, we have to go through multiple steps, right? These are the different steps. And then based on that, we decide that, yeah, out of 30,000, let's say 25,000 has more than 95% immunity, and remaining 5,000 has on an average 75% immunity. So we'll say more or less it will work with the 85% confidence, right? The similar kind of thing, if you see here, you know, we have so many examples, you know, that, like, for example, so Deloitte has floated a survey with around 1,000 people, and 54% agree that the plastic bags should be banned, you know. So then Deloitte can find, or Deloitte can make a statement that the maximum of the young generation or the population won't plastic bags to be banned, right? This is an statement that we had make with this kind of survey. Okay, cool. So these are the examples of different kind of survey based insight that you generate, and then you infer it to the larger population. Okay, the first thing that we'll study is the definition of statistics. Here we have the definition of statistic, that it's an art or it's a science dealing with some data, where we collect the data, perform some kind of analysis, generate insight, and then present it to the decision making board. So this entire exercise is called statistics. Okay, now as I said there, when we talk about statistics in this example, there are two kind of things, right? One was the entire population. This is the entire population, if I can say that. Yeah, this is entire population, isn't it? This is entire population. And when we have a sample, like, for example, 100, 10,000, 30,000, or not, this is called sample. So now, you know, in the next chapter, we will see there are two kind of thing. One is your population, and one is your sample. Sample is also taken from the same population. So either you can do some analysis on population directly, or you can do on sampling and on a sample, and then make a reference to the population. Example, census. So when the census happened every 10 years, I think, the census happens for the entire population. Like, you know, it happens every 10th year. I think the last happened in 2011. Yeah, 2021, it couldn't happen because of COVID and all. But 2011 census happens, where the government collects data about lot of KPIs, right? Like, what is the age, caste, income, and a lot of things, family size and all. So this is how the government they make better policies, for example, right? Sample, as I said, that COVID-19 vaccine, if I take example of COVID-19 vaccine, where we do the testing and everything on a sample and then think that, okay, if the vaccine has worked really well for 30,000 population from different state, different age group, different kind of medical background and all, it should definitely work well for the remaining population. Okay, so that's the sampling and the population. But there are few key terms and all which you should be aware of, you know, in the population and sample. Now, whenever you do any kind of analysis using the population, it will be called census, where we are gathering the data and everything from census, and the analysis that we'll perform on that will be called descriptive statistics. Okay, this the analysis which will be performed here will be called descriptive statistic. And whatever analysis we will perform on the sample, you know, where we collect the small set from the population itself, will be called inferential statistics. Okay, inferential statistics, because we try to infer what, you know, the population might behave or might look like based on the sample that, you know, we have today. Okay, the same kind of sample, if you had taken here, let's say you took a sample from just one state, okay, and you want to do age, caste, income and all, you know, you want to do that, do this kind of thing. The analysis that you will perform on sample, like mean, median, mode, what is the average salary, you know, what is the variance and all. And the same kind of analysis you can perform here also on the population, like what is the average age, what is the variance in their income and all, right? So when you perform the similar kind of thing on the population, you know, is called parameter. When you do the same kind of thing on population, right, it will call parameter. And when you do the same thing on the sample, it will call statistic. Not statistics, it will be called statistic, right? So that's the difference between a parameter and a statistic. Okay, so I'll write it down here, parameter and statistic. Now, parameter and statistic, the formula and everything will remain same, the average formula, variance and everything, only the notation will change. So I try to put the notation or the difference between them here. So for example, if you see here, the parameter or descriptive analysis and you know, statistic in inferential sample, average, here the average is represented by mu, here it's represented by x bar, right? Similarly, variance, sigma squared, here s squared, standard deviation, sigma and s. So the difference that you see in the population and the sample is that these mostly are the Greek words, right? Sigma, mu and all. And these are the mostly Roman words, x, small s and all. Okay, so this is the difference between the sample and the population, all this kind of thing. Okay, so please remember that. It might confuse you sometimes, like, okay, what is the mu, what is x bar and all. So whenever I say mu, think it like a average from the population, and if I say x bar, it's a population, it's an average of the sample. So that's the difference between these two entities. Okay, so till now, let me quickly revise what we have studied. We had seen example of population versus sample. Now, when we want to insert, when we want to launch a product, we cannot collect responses from the entire population. That's why we go ahead with a small population, a small sample size, and we make an inferential analysis that if this population think about our product like this, most probably the entire population of this particular bucket will think in that same manner. Okay, so that's what we understood and why it is important, we understood through the vaccine example, where I said that if a manufacturer wants to make a vaccine, COVID-19 vaccine for this age group, they cannot do the testing on entire population, 60 crore, right? So that's why they will do the testing in a phased manner, like 100, 10,000 and 30,000, and then make a general statement that if it is working really good in this population size, it should definitely work for the entire population size also. So that's the kind of analysis that we can perform using our sample and all. Then we talk about some of the key differences between a population parameters and all, and the sample keywords. Like, for example, here we call it descriptive analysis. Here we call them inferential analysis. The parameters and everything we collect here, like mu, sigma and sigma square, while here we collect x bar, s and s square. Okay, so that's the difference between sample and population. As of now, you don't need to worry much about where exactly mu is used, where exactly x bar is used, because we will read more about them in hypothesis testing and all. As of now, you just remember that when we say mu, it is population average. When we say x bar, it's a sample average. Okay. With that, I'll take a pause here and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.